And we'll now be speaking with Alice Goh's legal counsel, Attorney Stephen David. Attorney David, thanks for taking our call and welcome to the program.
Yes, good morning. Good afternoon. Good afternoon.
This is Carmina Constantino. You're live on ANC. One of your colleagues, Attorney Nicole Hamila, there, are saying that the court will have to issue an order for Alice Goh to attend the Senate hearing. Why is that so?
Because right now there is a warrant for her arrest issued by the RTC. Therefore, she is now under the jurisdiction of the courts. So whatever her moves right now will be first secured clearance from the regional trial court, which issued the warrant of arrest for her.
Senator Rizzo Ontiveros insisting that the warrant of arrest from the Senate came first. What do you say to that?
Yeah.
And that should be respected. Go ahead, Attorney David.
Yeah, it should be respected because the judiciary and the executive and the legislative are co-equal branches of the government, so they have equal power. You know, whatever it is always a check and balances. So if they will insist, of course they have the right. They are co-equal with the judiciary, but the problem is. Which will the PNP, di ba, follow the order of the RTC or the order of the Senate? Yan ang dilemma. It's beyond us now. Eh. Whatever the PNP will say, of course, we will just be there kasi wala naman tayong choice about that. Eh.
Pero kung kayo po ang tatanungin, saan po dapat nasa, kaninong poder dapat si Alice Goh ngayon po?
Well, Okay sa sa Senate kasi maganda yung detention facility doon, nandun si kapatid niya, no? So siguro mas comfortable siya doon. Pero really, I don't have the discretion on that. It will be the PNP which will decide where.
Have you been able to talk to your client, Attorney David?
Yeah, this morning, no, before she was brought to RTC.
And what did she tell you this time?
We will have to talk further pa kasi kanina, right? Now, we were surrounded with so many PNP, so we cannot really talk about the details of the cases. But after the PNP, after the RTC case, she will be brought back to the PNP custodial investigation. That is where I will be able to discuss with her thoroughly about our strategy. And of course, I will ask her to tell all dito sa Senate as to how and where she really went during those missing period na wala siya, di ba, during those time of fugitive siya. Yun naman ang concern ngayon ng Senate, eh, kung sino who are behind this escape.
Attorney David, I'm really going to have to ask you this question. The last time we talked, did you lie to us when you said that you did not know where she was? Because the day after, that was when Senator Rizzo Ontiveros came out with the expose that she's been out of the country since July.
Yeah. You know, right then when we were talking, she was, I cannot reveal that at this time because there was a lawyer-client privilege, no? But now, since she was the one who exposed everything in the media about the threats, Chinese mafias, spies, internal government, so inside the government. So now I can say na talaga, that was the reasons, one of the reasons why she was so hesitant to surrender herself. Kaya I really can understand why she cannot tell me exactly where she was at that time, because she might be thinking that probably my phone is bagged or probably I may not be able to control someone else to tell them that, oh, she's there, etc. So probably that's the reason why she cannot tell me really where she was exactly at the time.
But when did you know that she was no longer here? When did you know that she was no longer here?
Actually, from her, I never knew from her directly, only from Sheila, yung other client ko, na she told me na talaga magkasama sila. That was the only time I realized na walaan pala talaga siya sa Philippines, no, umalis sila.
And this was when? Can you give me a date?
That when we talked ng November 22.
November?
Ano ba itong buwan na to? August ba? Ano ba?
August. August September 22. Na po ngayon. Huli tayong nag-usap September, August.
That was August 22. August 23 when she was brought to the National Bureau of Investigation for inquest. That was the very first time I met and I talked I conferred with Sheila. So that was the time I learned from her that talaga they left the country.
But throughout, in the days leading up to that meeting with Sheila, you have been having phone calls with your client. Never did you ask her, not even once, where she was?
I was not able to communicate with her since August 22 in the afternoon until this morning lang. During all those periods, unang ko ang sabi sa kanya, oh, what happened? You made us worried for the past 8 or 10 days.
Well, Attorney David, you know that you're also in hot water. How do you then defend yourself to those who think that, you know, there's a thin line that separates lawyer-client privilege and obstruction of justice, Attorney David?
I don't know if I'm in hot water, pero I'm very confident na wala naman ako sa hot water. Siguro yun ang sinasabi sa media, but I don't see it.
So what are the expectations now? Where are you going to go from here, Attorney David?
Well, siyempre, we have to answer all the allegations, diba? Right now, where we saddled with the AMLA case, human trafficking, ito pa, nadagdag pa itong GRAP, and the COMELEC, so we will have to address all these things.
Mm-hmm. And what about security? I'm going to have to ask you that as well. Security on two fronts. One is that, you know, she has already said that she fears for her life. There are death threats being made. But there's also influence, her influence. She still holds that. So what are expectations in terms of security? San ho ba kayo mas panatag na masesecure po itong si Alice? Go ahead.
Based on my experience sa pagdating ng handling ng security ng clients, I handled so many controversial cases. I have full confidence in the capacity of the Philippine National Police. Kasi may history na sila. They already handled very controversial cases and they were very successful na provide nila ng security yung mga yun. So I don't have any reason to doubt yung capacity ng Philippine National Police, especially yung area sa custodial investigation, to protect the security of Mayor Alice Gu.
But if there's anything that all of these investigations have shown the public, it's that this syndicate that is operating within our shores, this criminal organization, they also have links to various agencies. Hindi ho ba?
That is the main reason why she cannot really, during those days, that is the one of the main reasons why she cannot turn herself into the jurisdiction of the authorities. Kasi nga, she did not know sino ang involved. She did not know mamaya, kausap niya, yun pala yung kalaban niya. So, she really did not know. That's why I really can't blame her why she cannot divulge her location at that time. But right now, custodial investigation, zeroing on it, we know how capable yung facility na yan because history event will tell us how they were able to secure VIP detention prisoners or detention people, people deprived of liberty.
Final question for you, Attorney David, before we let you go. In the past 24 hours, there have been, you know, reports that your client actually wanted to surrender weeks before she got arrested. Did you know about this?
Sino, si Mayor Alice?
Opo. What do you know?
I was discussing it with her. That's why even before the last time na we talked on August 22 in the afternoon, yung subject matter is about her surrender. In fact, she asked me to. She told me that she will just have to document everything so that whatever will happen, nandyan. Fortunately, siguro she was intercepted by some concerned people. Hindi na siya ng kanyang cellphone. Hindi na siya naka-access.
Meron mo ba kayong kinausap for her eventual surrender sa gobyerno po? Did you talk
to
anyone?
Of course. Higher authority. But I cannot, of course, divulge the identity. I was in constant communication with the authorities.
You were in constant communication with authorities prior to the arrest?
Yeah.
So they knew,
right now,
authorities
even now,
knew that...
Wesley, even now for her brother, Wesley, I'm in constant communication. Kaya lang, I cannot siyempre reveal sino, di ba? Basta they are in the higher position of the government para ma-secure naman at ma-facilitate yung pag-aresto rin. Kaya, pag-aresto, pag-surrender ni Wesley. Mm-hmm. Oh.
Kailan ang mangyayari?
I don't know, pero last night, he was very determined to surrender himself. Kasi nga, the futility of being a fugitive, di ba? Ano pa ba? Wala naman. Tsaka wala naman siyang kaso eh. Wala siyang kaso, mm-hmm. Bakit ka nagtatago?
Mm-hmm.
This is all about the Senate contempt order eh. Sabi ko na, pinapaliwanag ko eh. Mag-attend ka sa court, sa Senate. After that, kung okay ka na, wala ka naman kaso eh. So,
nasa,
why burden yourself?
Nasa okay. Indonesia pa ho ba si Wesley?
That, he did not confirm with me. Oh.
Hindi nyo rin ho tinanong?
No, I don't ask. Mm-hmm. Una, hindi naman nila sasabihin, magsisinungaling ka, hindi na. Oh.
Okay. So, ito pong nakita natin, yung pagka-aresto po kay Alice Go, inaasahan nyo na rin po to because according to you, you've been in constant communication with higher authorities that she will eventually surrender herself.
Actually, they were monitoring her eh. Mm. Alam naman nila eh, just that they cannot just intercept kasi nasa ibang bansa nga siya, di ba?
Mm-hmm.
So, kailangan ng proper coordination with the authorities in that country.
Mm-hmm.
So, pero, kaya nga, alam niya, sabi ko nga sa kanya, when Sheila and Cassandra were intercepted, that's really the final straw na nag-decide siya talaga na sumurrender na. That was in August 22.
Mm-hmm.
Yun talaga, she was decided, just that she really feared for her life. Kaya nga, dinodocument niya. But unfortunately, after that conversation, she never called again and I was not able to talk to her or text to her. In fact, all my messages were not seen. Eh. Di ba may seen mode?
Uh-huh.
May unseen, walang seen mode. Eh. Kaya we were worried, especially mga kabag-anak niya and friends. Ano nangyari, she was not even contacting anyone.
Okay. Will she be there come Monday at the Senate?
Well, hopefully she will. That's the natural process.
All right, we're going to have to leave it at that. Attorney Stephen David there. Alice Go's legal counsel, thanks again for taking our call. Really appreciate it.